Artist Naomi Lewis arranges small patterns to create larger organic-like images. And renowned acoustic blues musician Thomasina Winslow discusses her career and performs some music. It's all ahead on this episode of Aha! A House for Arts.
Funding for AHA has been provided by your contribution and by contributions to the WMHT Venture Fund. Contributors include the Leo Cox Beach Philanthropic Foundation, Chet and Karen Alpelka, Robert and Doris Fisher Melsardi, and the Robeson Family Foundation.
At M&T Bank, we understand that the vitality of our communities is crucial to our continued success. That's why we take an active role in our community. M&T Bank is pleased to support WMHT programming that highlights the arts, and we invite you to do the same.
I'm Jade Warwick, and this is AHA, a house for arts, a place for all things creative. Here's Matt with today's film segment.
I'm in downtown Albany to get a look at the very detailed work of artist Naomi Lewis. Let's go.
I respond to bringing order out of the chaos of the world in my art. I feel that that's one way I am able to do it. I slow down my world by creating these pieces that are about bringing new light to the ordinary. There are collections of materials that I have that I use and refer to build networks of small elements that are then growing into a larger whole. Objects of coral, of stones, insect wings, and then abstracting that to re-envision the ordinary. So each little element is repeated and dealt with as individually, but also part of a growing network, which in some ways reflects how individuals are in a larger society. I start by lightly sketching without a total plan. And then I do layers of building on that graphite and slowly building up the surface to give it more contour to create little nooks and hopefully create a surface that has room for the eye to move around and explore. As I gathered more and more references, I could shuffle through one and combine it with another, and going back and forth farther and farther towards pattern and then moving in towards texture, moving out towards a macro view and moving in towards a micro perspective too. I came upon the idea of taking some of the archived materials that I have in my possession, in my collections, and using those to create large wallpaper prints. I did work for a short time in a wallpaper production facility when I was younger, and realized that the process of repeating and tiling an original is the way that wallpaper is created. I started with a piece that I found in my drawer of a cheat sheet that my son was able to bring into his calculus final exam. And it looked like a beautiful object to me of all of these elements that were combined. And I literally scanned it to scale and used it as the background, and then created a drawn element that I added to the surface to contrast, to juxtapose, and to flesh out the concept of what you might want on your wall. I also work in cut paper. I began when the insects of the wallpaper appeared, the spiders, thinking that maybe I would use an accumulation of spiders as my organic element, and did some cut paper pieces that arranged the spiders in a circular pattern that created a web. What I do is draw the positive space and cut out the negative space. So it is a tedious process. It's very slow. I use an X-Acto knife on mulberry paper, and I work on this process that I find slows down time for me and is very meditative and counters the frenetic pace of our contemporary life. The process of working is the important part for me. The finished product doesn't matter as much as getting in here and continuing the journey, not knowing where it will take me.
Thomasina Winslow is a professional blues musician from Albany, New York. Not only does she perform her music for audiences worldwide, she also strives to pass on the tradition of the blues to the next generation. She does this through her educational program called STEAM. Let's learn more from Thomasina. Hi, Thomasina. Welcome to AHA today. I'm so happy to talk to you.
My pleasure.
To begin, I want to let the audience know a little bit of the genre of music you play. A lot of people may say blues, folks, roots, but personally, what do you think? What genre do you fall into?
I play acoustic blues, which is really Delta blues, which is really country blues, you know? So acoustic blues kind of keeps the confusion down as to what it is. When I talk about the styles of music or anything, and you know, you look at my website, it's acoustic blues and more. Mm. And that was the easiest way for me to open the door for people to understand that there's, you know, more that I do, but acoustic blues is where I'm most at home. And then I work with the band, I play classical, I study classical and have a degree in it. And I really like heavy metal too.
It's amazing. And you use the guitar with the acoustic
blues
too?
Yes, yes.
Do you play any other instruments?
I do. I play piano, other plucked instruments, ukulele, and mandolin.
Mandolin, nice.
I bought a mandolin because I wanted to learn this one Led Zeppelin song. And and a little bit on the banjo. I don't own one, but a little bit of banjo work, but guitar is my first love there.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Does being able to play all these types of instruments, or you mentioned metal and Led Zeppelin, being able to dive into all these different genres, how does that feel fulfilling as an artist? It must be.
It is. It's very much so. And it really kind of gives you a confidence as a musician to say, I know how this one works, and I know how to learn how the other ones work.
Yeah, and be able to collaborate with other musicians as well. You know, so we'll see you in a metal band. Who knows? So how did you get married to the blues? How did you find peace and fulfillment with this artistic musical craft?
I grew up with it, with a musical family, but I became attached to it with a combination of things. My parents were both from North Carolina, so the Southern culture is full of music. That's where a lot of what I do, Americana roots, where that came from. And I really like the combination of the culture, singing with my family, and I just wanted to keep doing it. And Odetta was one of my influences, so I met her, and I said, I want to do that, you know, I want to do that. And I was working with my family, too. So it was part of our livelihood, but it also really, I really gravitated to it.
And did any, like, family stories, like, just, I'm a blues fan myself, and you hear so much about, so much sung about what is seen through daily life. Did your family's daily life or any type of, like, did that inspire you at all?
That's a great question. What the blues were called before they were called the blues were called reels, R-E-A-L-S.
Okay.
And that's a part of the history. My great-grandfather played in the barrel houses. So he was a musician in the barrel houses, and that's when they what they call reels. But they played all of the music at the time, like Stephen Foster and that sort of thing. So that story about him, one of the big hits that people love to hear him sing was I Dream of Jeannie with the Light Brown Hair. That's that's not necessarily a blues, but the reels were songs that were about real life, so it was soap opera and song, you know? So different things, I wrote a little song about see them trees growing in the breeze, you know, and where we were living in the country. So all of that together really helped to build songs with the blues, and the blues helped you put it into a song form. And that it's user friendly in that way.
Oh, I love that. And that's why I love the blues too. It's just something soulful about it and connecting about it personally.
Yeah, you can say this pillow has a round circle.
See, there you go. Anything.
Yes.
So blues seems like it's very connecting and very community driven in a sense, I would say.
Yes.
I know you do an educational program, STEAM, and I know that also has to do with connecting and educational pieces. So would you like to give us a little bit of background about your educational program that you run?
Yes, STEAM, that acronym worked out so well because I worked with children at risk, and it is really strength-based programs are very important, as you know. When you're talking about teaching children life skills through music, which can be done, through the arts, which can be done, because it is life skills. You have to learn how to listen, you have to learn how to communicate. So when I left the classroom setting and decided to have my own independent education program, I thought to myself, I want a strength-based program. I wanted to be a mentoring program, not just a teaching program, but a mentoring in the expressive arts. STEAM, strength through expressive arts mentoring. It just
worked out.
It just worked out. It's like writing a song where you're taking dictation, you know. I created the program and presented it to the Office of Children and Family Services and started working with secure facilities. So incarcerated youth, so I was like, I want to do more. Mm-hmm. Well, that certainly was more from being in an unsecure facility to the secure facilities. And generally with any youth, their energy, with that energy and that talent is directed, you get some amazing results.
Yes.
And I have so many stories that I could regale you with for the next couple of programs. But one of the things I did is to record. So I recorded them, and their reaction when they hear their own voice. Mm. It's just, some were in tears. Some were like laughing and couldn't stop laughing. And I didn't, you know, get that, because to me that's feedback. But for them, it was feedback. They've never heard their own voice. So that's why I wanted to keep that going and have it be an expressive arts mentoring, because it's life skills as well as music.
And what type of skills do you teach them? Just like how to play, how to sing?
Yes, how to play and sing all of the instruments that are in a band. So your bass, piano, or keyboard, drums, and vocal. And even where it concerns with what they're doing with rap, guitar, mm-hmm. also. I don't know how we left that out. And the idea is to have them all have some competency in all of those instruments. So we're at a point where I can say, can someone do bass today? Yeah, I'll do bass. Someone do guitar today? Yeah, I'll do guitar. You know. And they feel so proud of themselves.
They love it, probably. And yes. Why do you think this type of accessible programming for at-risk youth is valuable for the community? Because it seems very valuable, but why do you find it valuable?
Well, I can answer that with one quick story. One of the students that I have, or that I had, was able to be discharged without any further, because of good behavior and that, and got a job in the same system and created her own STEAM type program. She didn't call it STEAM, but she created her own recording and producing program for kids that she was responsible for as a staff.
That's amazing. Teach one, so, reach one, and continue on.
Yes.
That's beautiful.
Yes, so it builds, I believe. And I've seen that more than once.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Thomasina, and thanks for coming by today and talking with us.
Thank you.
Please welcome Thomasina Winslow.
So the songs that I'm going to do are some of the most exciting I find enjoyable that I play. And this first one got a lot of attention on YouTube as a featured video, over 350,000 views. And it's called Rowdy Blues. Gonna marry, neither settle down. I'm gonna stay right here till they tear this barrel house down. Oh, I love you, babe, now tell their world I do. Oh, I love you, babe, tell their world I do love you. I don't love nobody in this whole round world but you. Ain't no use to weeping, ain't no need to cry. Ain't no use to weeping, ain't no need to cry. Cause you got a home just as long as I got mine. Oh, I love you, babe, now you're so nice and brown. Yeah. Oh, I love you, babe, you're so nice and brown. Cause you were put up solid, won't come tumbling down. Now did you get that letter I mailed in your backyard? Did you get that letter I mailed in your backyard? It's a sad word to say, but the best of friends have to part. This song is a, well, let's go to the club song from like 1927. Written by, or sung by Tommy McClellan. And again, another really exciting piece. You can kind of hear how the blues influenced funk when you hear this. So listen up for those cues, those bass cues. Shake him on down. Tell me, baby, don't you know it's true? Shaking that thing is good for you. Oh, must I holler? Yeah, must I shake him on down? Tell me, must I holler, baby, must I? Shake him on down. Tell me, baby, can't you see? Shaking that thing is good for me. Oh, must I holler? Yeah, must I shake him on down? Tell me, must I holler, baby, must I? Shake him on down. Shake it on down. Tell me, must I holler, baby? Must I shake him on down? If you ain't good looking, it's not the clothes you wear. Good kind treatment will take you anywhere. Oh, must I holler? Yeah, must I? Shake him on down. Tell me, must I holler, baby? Must I shake him on down? More time. Tell me, must I holler, baby? Must I shake him on down? Tell me, must I holler, baby? Must I shake him on down? This song is one of the classics by the master of Delta blues, called the grandfather of Delta blues, Charlie Patton. And it is another really exciting piece. I'm really into those exciting pieces. And you can hear the influence on funk, R&B, and everything in this one. This is called Moon's Going Down.
one of my favorites.
Thanks for joining us. For more arts, visit WMHT.org/aha and be sure to connect with us on social. I'm Jade Warwick, and thanks for watching.
Funding for AHA has been provided by your contribution and by contributions to the WMHT Venture Fund. Contributors include the Leo Cox Beach Philanthropic Foundation, Chet and Karen Opelka, Robert and Doris Fisher Melsardi, and the Robeson Family Foundation.
At M&T Bank, we understand that the vitality of our communities is crucial to our continued success. That's why we take an active role in our community. M&T Bank is pleased to support WMHT programming that highlights the arts, and we invite you to do the same.